Hey, this is Ralph, and in this video, I want to show you how you can customize the Microsoft Word Quick Launch Area or the ribbons. Now, I'm doing this in Microsoft Word, but really it works with any of the Microsoft Office applications. And I could see you wanting to do this for the popular ones like Excel as well. So right at the top of any of the ribbons, we have what's called the quick launch area. So I'm looking up here in the top left corner, and I'm not using my quick launch area very much. A little bit before the video, I just removed a bunch of icons. So I've got auto save and save, but I want to add some more things up there. The nice thing about quick launch, it's one button to perform an action, and you'll get the same quick launch display regardless of which ribbon you happen to be using. So I can click on this little drop down menu, go all the way to the bottom, and let's see, I'm going to choose more commands, and I'm in the quick access toolbar, which I've been calling quick launch. So the quick access toolbar, and you've got some choices for that right up here. You notice over on the right, I've only got auto save and save. That's pretty boring. So you might put things on here that you just want to click on a lot that you're frequently doing. So you see there's an option to email as an attachment. If that's something you're doing a lot, then by all means, you can take that and just add it to the right and you bring it over. It's now going to be part of your quick launch, quick access toolbar. And let's find something else that I might do a lot. Page setup, I might do a lot. So I'll add that over to the list. So I'm popping these things over, and you can reorder them, by the way, too. So you can click on any one item and then just use the arrows, the up and down arrows, to rearrange that order. I'm going to click OK, and we'll see that I now have the page setup. So I can just click that button right up there in the top left. I go right into page setup, or I can click the button to send an attachment. This file, there's that document, and it goes right into my email. It's a pretty useful one if you do that a lot. And of course, I've got auto save and save. If I'm not using auto save though, then by all means, more commands, go to that auto save option, remove it from the list. That feature is not gone, it's just not on your quick access toolbar. Okay, but let's go above and beyond the quick access toolbar. And what I want to do next is I want to create a custom ribbon with groups that I might use for schoolwork and things like that. So I'm going to click on that customize button, go to more commands, and this time over here on the left, I'm going to go to customize ribbon. So you can see there are different ribbons available to me, and I've got most of them checked. I don't display the draw ribbon just because I'm using a desktop computer, and that's got a lot of features that might be good for people that are using a Microsoft tablet or Surface Pro or something like that. However, what I'm going to do is all the way at the bottom here, I'm going to click on new tab. And that's going to create a new tab for me. Now it's creating it basically right where I had something selected, but I can move it around later on. Now what I'm going to do first is I'm going to right click on the words new tab and rename it. And I'm going to go ahead and call that school, and I'll click OK. And it gives me a new group as well. I'm going to right click on that new group and rename, and I'm going to call it, actually I can get a little color if I want to use the little green icon, and I'm going to call this WR121 for writing 121, popular class that pretty much all college students have to take at some point. So I'm going to click OK. So now what you can do with this command group, this ribbon group, is you can add commands to that group for that particular topic or class. So let's say for writing 121, something I'm doing a lot in there, and is I'm changing fonts. Okay, so I'll bring font over, and I just dragged it right over. And let's say I'm doing font size, I'll double click on, I can't double click it, I'll just drag that over. So I've got font size, and we'll do one more. How about save? Let me put save over there. I'll put save above font. Again, you can click on any one of these and just reorder them with the up and down arrows. So now I have my writing 121 group. Let me click OK. And you'll notice now I have a school ribbon as one of my choices. When I click on that, I've got my writing 121 group with features in there that I use a lot for that class. I'm going to click on my customize again, more commands. And I'm going to make sure I'm customizing the ribbon, and I'm going to activate my school custom. I'm going to click on new group. Let's say there's another group that I'm doing. Let me right click on that new group and rename. And maybe this is AV for aviation, 211, Aviation 211. I'm totally ignorant on that particular set of courses, but maybe there are features in there. I'll just go ahead and grab a couple today. I'll just drag a few more. And by the way, there's tons more commands available. I could go to all commands and you're going to get a huge list on here of various items. Let's see, I'll just grab something here. New list, put that over there. Cool, so now I've got two command groups. I'm going to click OK. And now my school ribbon has a group for my writing course and for my aviation course. There you go. So that's all it takes in order to customize the quick access toolbar, which is visible at the top for all ribbons. And then of course you can customize your own ribbon for whatever purpose you need and then make groups for focused areas within that ribbon. Thanks for hanging out with me.